Hi, welcome to our next part in the Type By course series. In this video, we walk through step by step on how you can leverage your data pipeline with some of Type By course most notable features, like creating pipelines with two essential components, data nodes and task. Let's get started right away. Here we are using a large dataset of the liquor sales data from a location. We have multiple attributes such as the invoice number, the date of transaction, the location, volume, cost, and quantities. We'll be using this dataset for our Type By course series. This is a fairly large dataset with a lot of entries, and we will build a fairly simple exemplary pipeline to mimic a real-world use case to analyze this data and showcase Type By smart features. Our simple data pipeline has two main tasks or functions. The first task, filter the raw data, and keep only the relevant columns and outputs a pandas data frame. Then for the second task, we aggregate our data based on a store number and calculate which store has the highest sales amount. Then return that store ID. So let's now create a Python script file for our two main functions. So here's our Python script file for our two main functions. The simple filter function performs two tasks on the input data frame. Firstly, it filters the data frame to retain only a subset of columns specified by the selected columns list, which includes the columns invoice number, date, store number, sales dollar, and zip code. Secondly, the function generates and returns a summary of the input data frame using the describe method, which provides statistical information such as the mean, standard deviation, and percentiles for each numeric column in the data frame. So let's get to Type By Studio and set up our pipeline. Let's create a new config file and call it myconfig. So the first thing to do is to set up the scenario and a pipeline. So let's call it main scenario. Now, we need to set up our two main tasks. So let's call it simple filter and get top store. Now we need to configure this task in Type By Studio. If you click on the task in the red box by default on the left-hand side of the screen, you can see under the details tab. In order to link a Python function to a task, simply click on the plan icon for function. Then navigate through the Python module in your project and choose the function that you want to use. So in this case, we're using simple filter. And let's now configure the task getHopStore. As you can see here, for the first task, we have one input and two outputs, and we can use the output of simple filter as the input of the second task to get top store. So let's now configure the four data nodes that we'll be using. First is the input of simple filter. We know that this data node needs to hold the input data frame, and thankfully, we tap by built-in feature, you can simply add a data node, and then specify the storage type, so in this case, a CSV file. And then enter the default path to your CSV file. So it's under New Property. Click on Default Path, and then enter the path to the dataset. Let's now set up the intermediate data nodes and the output data nodes. After configuring your pipeline with Type By Studio, it will automatically save the configurations as a TOML file. So now, all you need to do is to load it to the Python script and execute the pipeline. Here's the general syntax to load the configurations file from Type By Studio. We also need to specify the scenario configurations. After that, we will call typebycore.run to initiate typebycore service and create a new scenario entity from the scenario configs that we just loaded. Now is the fun part. In order to execute the scenario, simply call the submit function on the scenario entity. Let's also print out the result of our pipeline by accessing the output data node, which is topsore ID. So here, I'm executing the code. And as you can see, the first task is executed successfully. It prints out the type of the content inside the input data node, which is the pandas data frame exposed type. So let's scroll down a bit, and we see that the second task is also working perfectly. With TypeBy Studio and the power of TypeBy Core, your pipeline can be modularized and always executed in the right order. And that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll show how you can significantly save the development time with TypeBy Core's cacheable feature, which can automatically skip redundant and previously executed tasks. Thanks for watching.